You know, Luke, we really have a challenge when you talk about data normalization. So in order to allow the technologies and the algorithms associated with the machine learning and artificial intelligence technologies, we have to be able to have data sets that are aligned and normalized for those scripts to actually run on. And I think Tyler really hit it on the head. You know, being able to do a lot of pre-work and setting up the data so that it's ready to be crunched, if you will, by the algorithms is all good if you're doing analytics, deep analytics on specific subjects for research type efforts. But when you're talking about data streams in real time in order to respond to events that are happening in the enterprise, that's a different way to look at the problem. So you have to normalize the data and have it in a common data store, if you will, a configuration management database in our case, so that you can run those scripts on it, so that you can take action. I mentioned previously anomalous behavior being an example, in near real time, so that you understand what's happening in your environment. That's a different approach to applying the technology. It's something not all agencies have really wrapped their heads around yet, and it's a significant challenge going forward when you look at applying this to a real-world set of data in real time.
Yeah.